In this video, I will be explaining about Google's NotebookLM. It's a very useful AI application. It is provided by Google. We have free version also. And apart from that, if you want to have more features, you can upgrade to plus paid version. Okay. You can access it just by typing notebooklm.google.com on the browser. And I already created one notebook. You can create many notebooks, but as I said, in free version there should be some limitation in creating notebooks and other limitations. I will be talking about it later. And if you want to create a notebook, just click this create new. First, let me explain what is this basically. Okay, it's useful for research. Okay. And not only for academic research, for any kind of thing. Say, for example, if you are planning to write an article, and if you want to refer 4 or 5 PDF files and 2 or 3 audio files, you can just upload everything here. Okay, and then you can ask questions, and you can ask it to summarize that, and even you can talk to that. Okay, and lot of features are there. So basically, you can get complete details about that materials. Okay, so it will be useful for like if you are studying for something, and if you have collected a lot of notes, and if you find it difficult to organize them or get information from them, you can just upload everything here, and you can create one single notebook, and from there you can get a lot of information by charting, by creating a summary, other things. Let me explain those things. Okay, so the first step is adding sources, then using them. Okay, that is the concept of this Google NotebookLM. It's a very simple thing. Okay, just visit notebooklm.google.com, and you can just start using it. Just create this new notebook, and you can upload files, PDF files, and text file, markdown, audio. Okay, or you can take it from Google Drive, or you can provide link, YouTube link or website links, or even you can just simply paste the content. Okay, it's that much easy. Just you have to add the sources, and then you can start using it. Okay, to save the time, I'll be showing already added thing. Okay, this is new one, right? So I'll be opening this already added one. Okay, here I already added one PDF file. We can add any number of sources, any number of sources. In the sense, in the free version, there will be some limitations. Okay, but it's okay for regular usage. It's okay. Okay, and here, once after adding that, you can chat with that. Okay, you can ask questions. Okay, you can ask it to write summary. Even it is suggesting some pre-made questions. Okay, what are risks of generative AI? So it's my book about using AI for business. Okay, so there I mentioned those things. So based on the content, it automatically generated questions. Okay, so here it's talking about risk, right? So it's listing the risks. Okay, based on the content, that is the important thing about NotebookLM. Okay, we can suppose if you want to talk to something, you can use ChatGPT Gemini, right? They are trained with a lot of data, huge amounts of data, right? So they can do effectively for that publicly available information. But suppose if you want to do like this, so your own notes or private information, if you want to talk to that information, we cannot use ChatGPT and Gemini directly. We can go with RAG, other things, but that needs a lot of time and efforts, coding. Like we have to create vector database embeddings, you have to create and store that, and you have to write coding, right? So that kind of things are there. Okay, but in this case, NotebookLM, it's very effective for end users. Anyone can easily start using it. Just upload the content and talk with that. The information output will be grounded in the sense that it won't be affected by hallucinations, other things. Okay, because you are providing information, so based on that information only it's going to give the output. Okay, so you will be getting citations like this. Okay, references. Okay, so here suppose if saying something means it will be referring based on which chapter it's giving this answer. So we can understand that it's reliable. Okay, this is a core concept. Okay, we can chart with this book content. Not only this only book, we can, as I said, we can add any number of sources. Okay, suppose if you want to add another book, we can just add that book also. If it is PDF, we can add here. Okay, for beginners, I will add this book. Okay, so it will be added. Okay, now we can start with both books. Okay, charting is one feature. Similarly, it is having a lot of features. Okay, I will show the already created one to save time. Okay, we can create study guide, we can create a FAQ, we can create timeline, we can create this one briefing doc. So everything will be useful for research kind of thing, for writing articles or academic research or business research. Okay, suppose if you are handling multiple documents and audio files or slides, you can put everything here and you can combine, get combined information in various formats through chart, through these kinds of study guide, FAQ, briefing doc, timeline. Apart from that, this audio, it's a very, very important one. It will be very useful, like podcast also. I'll be showing the demo, then only we can easily understand that. Okay. So first, let me show these things. Okay. Here we can ask questions. The question itself is suggesting. We can ask our own questions also. The answers will be grounded. We can get the reference or citations. So it's somewhat reliable. Okay. That is the unique thing about this one. Okay. And here, as I said, we can create a timeline like this. Okay, we can create, in the sense we have to just click the button, it will be automatically created. So purely based on the book content. Okay, so based on the book content, it is giving the timeline information. According to this book, it's just saying present, future, upcoming, like that. But if it's history or something, it will be giving exact dates, other things. Okay, so this one, FAQ. Already created a FAQ, right? Okay, now I'm generating with both content. Okay, based on two sources. Previously I created one FAQ based on single source. So based on the two ebooks, it has created this FAQ. What are the main types of artificial intelligence models and how do they differ? Okay, how does AI model learn and how is improved over time? It's summarizing both book contents and creating question as well as answer. What are the common application of AI in daily life and various industries? So suppose if you are having 10-12 books, you can easily combine all the information and you can get the details. Okay, so if you similarly study guide also there. So this one study guide, right? So it has created a quiz also, questions, and it provided answers also, answers key and essay questions, glossary of key terms. It has created automatically, okay, based on the book content. So these are all really useful for learning, right? And well, the key thing is, as I said, this podcast kind of audio. Okay, you have to just click interactive mode. Okay, you will be getting two people talking about this content. Okay, so from that we can easily get a lot of information. Okay,
welcome to the deep dive. Okay, let's cut through the noise. Today we're diving into something really practical, AI for entrepreneurs. It's based on Rajamadikamanthanamuthu's guide.
Yeah, the subtitle is a practical guide to using AI in your business, and that's exactly our focus.
Right, our mission really is to pull out the key insights, the stuff you as an entrepreneur can actually use now. No need for a computer science degree.
Exactly. We're not just, you know, giving a book report. We're trying to find those useful nuggets that could genuinely impact your business. And Demuthi's guide is pretty grounded. It takes you from the basics right up to generative AI.
Which is everywhere now. But yeah, the whole AI landscape can feel a bit much, right? All the jargon, the constant revolution.
Totally overwhelming sometimes.
So we want to give you a clear path. What really matters for making your business more efficient, helping it grow. Where can AI give you that actual edge?
Let's find out. So chapter one starts with the basics, right? Understanding AI in simple terms.
Yeah, and get straight to the point. Forget the Hollywood robots. We're talking about software, machines, doing tasks that usually need human intelligence.
It's about augmenting, helping out, not like total replacement.
Right, which is key for entrepreneurs, I think. It's about tools. So what can it realistically do right now? And maybe where are we getting ahead of ourselves?
Good question. Okay, so the guide highlights automating routine stuff first. Think scheduling, answering those repetitive customer questions, managing email.
Oh, the email black hole.
Yeah, exactly. It's about getting back your time. You know, that's your most valuable thing, freeing you up from the mundane to focus on, well, growth.
Makes sense. Then there's data.
Okay, we can also join here. Okay.
Oh, hey, I think our listeners got something to say.
Okay. Okay. Can you give some overview about this book?
Great to have you chiming in. Where were we? Ah, yes, AI and data.
Right. AI's ability to crunch numbers and spot trends can be a real game changer for businesses.
Absolutely. It can help you understand your customers better, predict market shifts, all that good stuff.
What stands out to you so far? Anything in particular sparking your interest?
Well, we were just about to move into how AI can impact customer experience.
Instant support and more personalized marketing efforts.
What are your thoughts on that? Have you had any interesting experiences with AI?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Can you talk about hallucinations, whether it is mentioned this way?
Absolutely. That's a really important point to bring up.
Yes, the guide by Antimamuthu does discuss hallucinations in AI.
Okay, let's unpack this term a little. What exactly are AI hallucinations?
Essentially, it's when an AI model generates information that sounds plausible but is actually false or nonsensical.
So it's not making things up maliciously, but it's just wrong.
Exactly. The AI is predicting responses based on patterns in its training data. If it lacks accurate information, it might guess or fabricate details.
That sounds a bit concerning for businesses relying on AI.
It can be. The guide highlights the risk of misinformation, poor customer experiences, or even legal issues if you're not careful.
So what does Antetokounmpo suggest to mitigate these hallucinations?
He emphasizes the importance of human oversight. Always have experts review AI-generated content, especially for critical areas.
That makes sense. You can't just set it and forget it.
Not at all. Continuous monitoring is also key to flag any unusual or incorrect outputs for review.
And I imagine the quality.
Yep, go on.
Okay. Yeah. Can we talk about how to start using AI in business?
Definitely. That's really the heart of what we're discussing.
Absolutely. And the guide by Antetokounmpo has a whole chapter dedicated to this.
Chapter 4, Building Your First AI System, is all about getting started.
The very first step is to define a problem in your business that you think AI could solve.
Be really specific about the outcome you're hoping for.
Whether it's improving customer service or automating some marketing tasks.
Don't just say use AI, pinpoint an area where it can make a real difference.
Then the next step is to choose the right AI tool for that specific problem.
There are so many out there, so it's about finding one that fits your needs.
He touched on some examples like chatbots for customer support.
Exactly. Once you've picked a tool, the next stage is training.
Okay, I stopped it. Okay. So it's really useful, right? We can add a lot of good sources and then we can use this podcast kind of things. And even we can join and ask questions and set the direction, right? So it's really useful. Okay. And if you want to use it, just visit notebooklm.google.com. Basically, it is internally using a RAG kind of things, okay? Maybe it might be using a Gemini, though they are not officially telling it. Based on the response, people are predicting that it should be using Gemini. Okay. Even we can set up the same thing with the RAG and API. But this one already they provided in an effective way, right? So we can just make use of it as they are providing it free. Okay. So we can just upload the files, start asking questions or creating podcast or creating FAQ timeline and briefing documents and study guides. Okay. Thanks.